I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Are you going to spar Hector Tenhara today?
I don't know. Where are we putting my weight?
Yeah, go for us.
Both guys.
Hector's talented.
I don't know why. Hector's too tall. Danny's not that tall. Five.
He just had his birthday, Brandon.
I know, he's 21 now. He's legal.
Where were you at 21?
21? Here.
You're a pro fighter already?
Oh, here. I turned 18. Ellie, my first pro fight was 18, motherfucker. I just got to tell you that. What the fuck? Fuck! Ellie, I was here at 18. First, I turned pro here at age 18.
So you left the house at 17?
18.
No, you left the house. You left your parents.
I left my parents' house at age 15.
Where'd you live?
I was with my first relationship. My baby mama.
At 15, that's young.
I know, I was young. I left, I was young. And then I was right here with, and I came over here. I met Robert at the 2004 Olympics, at the Olympic trials.
Is that the one in Kansas?
No, that was the one in,
so I don't know.
Fuck, I think it was in Mississippi.
They have much water over
here. I don't remember what year it was. But I met Robert right there. And then from there, I got all the way. I got second. So I made it to the.
You know the guy?
I made it to Cleveland, Ohio to fight Mickey Bay. I had to beat him twice just to make the Olympic team. And he beat me the first day, so I was like, fuck it. So,
yes, I know that.
And did he make the Olympic team?
He lost in the qualifiers.
To who?
Huh?
To who?
I don't know. But the reason why I didn't get to go to the Olympic team,
because he beat you.
Because, no, I couldn't win. I couldn't, because he had a qualifier. I couldn't win. But if I would have went to training camp. I know that about that. I know you can go to training camp to qualify to try to compete.
Yeah,
in case the first qualifier missed, I can try out for the second qualifier. But I know that, so we just turned pro right away.
But you
came and gave me the good deal. At that time, it was Shelly Finkel. I was supposed to sign with him at that time, and Robert called me later. And now, it was Sam Cameron Duncan.
That's how Guerrero just
I came over.
It was a 140.
But you know what?
I didn't know nothing. I didn't know Robert was a fighter.
You know, he has a fighter.
I thought he was training.
Lost to this guy.
When I came over, when I came to the first day, I was like, "Fuck, bro, who did you train?"
Percy
guy. He was white. Like, who's those titles? Who's all those? Because IBF, the NABF, I seen all that shit. I was like, "Hey, fuck, who the fuck did you train, bro?"
He
was those are my belt. I was like, "What the fuck you mean?" He's like, "Yeah, I'm a fighter." I was like, "Shut the fuck up." Yeah, I fought Castillo. I fought Corrales. I fought Bentaki. I was like, "Dude, for real?" Yeah, he showed me the picture. He showed me the videos. And I was like, "Oh, fuck."
You laughed when you saw him get knocked out?
Yeah, I made fun of him a lot of times.
I asked him this week if he ever won knockout of the year. He said yes when Ben Tacky knocked him out.
Yeah, that's how he won it, knockout. Because that was a nasty knockout. He motherfucking turned his body. Like, I thought he was an exorcist for a little bit. Because all you see is he's just turned. But yeah, dude, that's how I fucking.
But Brandon.
Ever since then, you know, I've been. Like I said, me and Robert, we had a connection, bro, because, you know, Robert knows. Like, I was straight, you know, I was like a fucking, like. I'll tell him how I feel, I'll tell him how it is, you know what I mean? So that's how we became a good relationship, and then one led to another. He became the best man, he became my Nino, and now, I'm connected for life, eh?
Reporting. Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best, Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you're watching, EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing them.